Hey guys, this is Aaron. I want to show you something that may come in handy for you if you ever have to model from reference images. I have a model here of a jet I did, and as much as I would like to say that I modeled this from scratch, that would be a lie. I did use reference images. So I actually have them on their own layer over here. If I turn my reference layer on, you'll see I have a series of images that I used as references. I have scenes up here at the top, so I can jump to a top view, side view, front view real quick while modeling, and I can actually see that projected reference, so I can model real quickly and jump between the different views. We're going to go ahead and create something like this, sort of a reference image cage like this in a new drawing. So I'm going to go ahead and go File New. I'm going to go ahead and blow that up nice and big so you guys can see everything I'm doing. And I'm going to let Chris leave. He does not have to stick around for this. I'm going to now go to import and import my reference image. So I have a Vespa image. I'm going to go ahead and import that and drop it on the ground. I'm not real concerned with the scale at this point. We've done a lot of, talked about scaling before. At this point, I just want to talk about setting up the cage. So my reference image actually contains all of the different sides that I want to reference on one image. I don't have to do it this way. I could actually import a series of images, top, side, front, but what's important is that I do have the three reference images and that those three reference images are about the same scale. I mean, relatively, if scaled to the same width, they're about the same height, that sort of thing, so that I don't have issues where I'm having to stretch the image or something like that in order to make everything line up. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by taking this and I'm actually going to set this up as the side. So I want this image, this side image, to be here in the blue-green quadrant. So I'm going to start by using my rotate tool. I'm going to hit the right arrow key to lock onto the red axes and click to the endpoint. And then click on the side and bring it straight up. So I click onto the blue axis. Now I'm going to flip it around the other direction. So I'm going to click the bottom. Click and drag that around till it snaps to the green axis. All right, now it's where it needs to be. It's on the right plane, but I gotta move where the actual image is. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the move command, and I'm gonna click on this ground plane, and I'm going to hit the up arrow to lock to moving vertically, and lock that right there. And I'm gonna use move again to kind of slide it over. Again, this is not of dire importance where exactly this is lined up, but see, what I generally want to do is just have that the geometry in the positive space of this quadrant right here. All right, once that's done, we can set up the rest of the images. So what I want to do is I want to get this piece right here turned around so it's on this blue-red quadrant right here. I'm going to do that using the rotate command. So I'm going to come to my origin, I'm going to hit up to lock to the blue axis, and I'm going to click and drag this around. So I want to get it to right here, but I want to keep my other one too, so I'm going to use my modifier key. This is Option on the Mac or Control on Windows, and I'm just going to bring it around and click right there. So you can see what I'm doing here. I have two of my images set up already. I'm going to go back to selecting the first image, rotate again. This time I'm going to use the green axis, grab the bottom, and again, modifier key to copy, and bring that up like that. So there I have those three images. I'm almost set up as far as having those in the right spot to use as a reference. One thing I'm gonna have an issue with right now, of course, is that they don't all line up. Specifically, this bottom one does not seem to be where it needs to be. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna draw a couple lines referencing in a reference point. For a reference point, I'm gonna use the front of this fender right here. So I'm gonna draw a line right there, click, and I'm gonna draw a line out. I want to stay on the red axis, so I'm going to go ahead and hit the right arrow on my keyboard and then come to this point right here. I'm going to draw that back just so I have that reference. Draw this down. So basically, the front of the fender should align to this point on all three images. So now I can come in and I can fine-tune any of my images. So if that's not quite where I want it, I could move it. This one's a little bit off, so I'm going to come in here and use the move command to kind of right about there is good. This one's way off, so I'm going to, oops, select this and move it right there. All right, once I have that done, I can actually get rid of these lines. I don't need them, I just need to reference them for placement, but I'm pretty good. So now it's cleanup time. So one of the things I want to do is go in and crop these images real quick. I don't need all these additional views of the Vespa on the side view. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and cut this down to just what I need. I can't actually cut down an image, but what I can do is I can right click and explode that image. When I explode it, it becomes just a surface with the image painted on as a texture. So what I can do now is use move to just move these lines back. There we go. Do the same thing to the side. Select, move, and bring it down. Whoops. I can bring it down. The bottom one up. And I can take this one all the way up to the reference plane. I don't need it to hang down there at all. And then finally, I bring this one in here like that. So that's all I need out of that image. I'm going to go ahead and do that to the other images. Just explode and move their edges real quick. Okay, so at this point, I have my three images in and cropped. And last couple things I'm going to do is just to set it up so it's easier to reference them. If I jump to my side view, and see that's a pretty good view, I like that. I can jump, same thing, to the front view, top view. But one of the issues you come up with here is I'm not actually looking at it directly straight on. I'm actually looking at it in my perspective view. That's going to add a little bit of distortion, especially when we reference one image to the next. So one of the things I want to do before I set up my reference scenes is go up to camera and turn on parallel projection. There we go. Now I'm looking at just that one image. So the other images are still there, but when I snap into that view, see, I'm just seeing that image. So these quick view buttons are at the top are great, but I'm going to go just a step further and actually create scenes for each of these. So I'm going to create a scene for the side view, and I'm going to go ahead and select it, make sure my additional information is dropped down, and I'm just going to change the name to side. That way, as I'm modeling around here, if I want to jump back to a side view, all I have to do is just click on this and I'll jump back over there. I'm going to do the same thing for the other two views real quick. Okay, so I've got my views created. One thing I might want to change though is that animation. So I'm going to go do just kind of one more thing right here. Go to View, Animation, and change my settings and actually just turn off Enable Transitions. What that's going to do is allow me to just real quickly hop from one to the next. Real quick and easy. All right, last thing I may want to do here, select all these, go to Entity Info, and add them to a new reference layer. That's going to allow me, as I model, to just flip these all back on and off again. So there you go, a quick and easy way to make a set of reference images for modeling. Thank you.